Hello guys, welcome. So this will be a very short tutorial, and this will be our lecture 4. So we covered arrays, and we covered fixed size arrays includes like 1D, 2D, 3D arrays, and also we covered in that lecture on packed and unpacked arrays, right? So generally, like, fixed size arrays are nothing but the unpacked arrays. So packed arrays is a classification where you can have a continuous operations, right? In a continuous, you can allocate the memory, so you can access one time, you can put the data, right? You don't need to put it separately, right? So this was in the previous lecture, lecture number 3. In this lecture, it's a very short lecture because most of the things we covered there. After this, we will cover some more arrays, but like, I want to put the topics separately, which becomes easier to go through. Okay, so this is lecture 4, dynamic array. So what is dynamic array? So dynamic array, you can understand from the term, right? This allocation of the memory happens at the runtime phase, right? So so what happens at the runtime phase? So you just need to say, okay, I am allocating the space for that. So you will use the variable new to allocate the space. And so the simulator will know, oh, okay, I need to allocate the space, so it will create some space. It can create space like up to your size. Suppose you want to say like 4 size, right? So you will say like, okay, 4 space you want, right? 4 bit of space you want. You can just write new and then 1 and whatever is the range, right, it will allocate. So suppose there's an integer data type here, d underscore array, so it will allocate 32 bits space, right? You say new 2, so it will like allocate 32 to 64 space, right? You could have the bit data type, and you can have like unpacked operation, like 3.20, suppose you write down, and then d underscore array, so it will allocate 4 bits of space, right? So it depends. So new will be different for different data types, right? How you are writing the declarations. Here we have the integer declarations, d underscore array, so it will be 32 bits. Now you see, I'm allocating the line number C, I'm allocating more number of values, right? So it doesn't care, you have allocated some space, you're asking the memory to allocate some space. You can, at the runtime itself, you can put some values, right? It will allocate, it will extend the memory in that way, right? So you are writing that d underscore array, it take h 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and up to 7. So it is like integer data type. So it is storing that values now, right? Now, how you're publishing that values, you are publishing like how you publish for the unpack, right? D underscore array I, and you're displaying all these values. So you, in the second portion, you can see I'm displaying the values, right? 0 to 7. And also I'm showing you the size, like the size of the dynamic array d underscore array is 8, right? You have the 8 values, right? So you have 8 space. That is your size. Now, what you can do is, you can copy in a way data, right? So suppose d underscore array is equal to new 4 and d array I've written. Instead of d underscore array 1, I would suppose use a d underscore array. What will happen that it will take a copies of first 4 values, right? And then it will be like an empty space, right? So you can delete the data in a way, right? In this way. Okay, so that's what it can do. And here I'm doing what? D underscore array 1, new 4, and D array. So I'm saying allocate 4 space memory for me. And in that 4 space, because D underscore array is of 8 size, right? So I will allocate like 4 values from D underscore array to the new space that I've given 4, right? Now suppose D underscore array new 4 I've written, then it will allocate new 4 space, right? And whatever data was there actually, right, that would have gone, right? So because you have not allocated that space, right, now you're allocating that space, right? So you're allocating the space now in the runtime phase, right? So that's what I'm d underscore array 1 I'm doing. So you can see that 0, 1, 2, 3 is retained, okay, and I'm publishing that data. Now you can also delete that data, d underscore array dot delete, right? It will delete that array itself. And now I'm displaying that, you see, the size of d underscore array is 0. So it has gone now, right? So in dynamic arrays, we have seen how to allocate space, then what is the function of dynamic array? Right? At the runtime, you are allocating some space, right? So this is the very short lecture of dynamic array. And next, we'll be going for the associative arrays in the next lecture. Thanks.